Okay, so we're back to continue our embellishing now of the medium box. This box is going to be called Explore. So I've gotten a few things together already. I have this die cut. Let me show it to you. It's a Spellbinders die cut. So I thought this would be cute to put a little globe, and I had paper from the, actually I think I had to buy this paper. Yes, I think I bought this paper individually, probably from Michaels, and I cut out, as you can see, part of this globe over here to make the globe. What I want to do though is I don't want it to be just black cardstock. I don't want it to look like that, so I think what I'm going to try to do, and I don't know if this is going to work, so I'm going to just try it, is I'm going to try to use some of this solid bronze just a little bit. But you know what? No, I don't think it's solid bronze I want. I think it's copper. Hold on just a second and let me find my copper. Hold on. Okay, it's antique copper I think I want to use instead of bronze. I just wanted to give it kind of like a metallic-y looking, you know, base, because it's a stand, right? So, and again, I'm not sure if this is gonna work. I'm just gonna try it. So, if I had silver, I probably would use silver, and I should have probably put a piece of paper underneath this, but. So I'm just like kind of like dry brushing it on a little bit now at this point, because I do want that some of that black to show through, right? Okay, let's see what it would look like. I think that's gonna work. I didn't want it black because the box, you know, is not. I think that's gonna work. So let's let that dry. All right, so I'm gonna let that dry, and I'm gonna wipe off my area here so I don't get this paint everywhere. I should have put down a piece of paper. I wasn't thinking about that. All right, quick and easy clean up. This is a oven liner that I got at Walmart for like $7. It's a great craft mat. And as you can see, it ends up pretty simply easy. Okay, so we're gonna let that dry, but this right here, what I want to do is I don't know if y'all can tell, but the land has been embossed. I embossed it, and so I want to kind of make that pop. I think I'm gonna use the good old vintage photo. Let's see if what I've got on here will work, because I don't want it to be too much, you know? But I do want it to shine. Yeah, that'll work, I think. Let's get these edges. I think that's gonna look cute. Yeah. Okay, and then we can decide which way we want to put it. Yeah, that'll work, right? Oh yeah, see, look. I think that's gonna be perfect. This is almost dried. We're gonna set this aside. Now, I have my flowers that I made yesterday. They're completely dried. And I don't know if y'all can see it, but in the light, in person, they are very glittery, but not glittery. They're just, I don't know, they're very pretty. The only thing is, I do have different colored gold. And I think I needed to use more of a darker gold than the champagne gold. And that's what I'm going to try the next time with the paint. Because I think that will end up working. And then these little guys look like this, which I think they turned out super cute, right? So, yeah, I think they turned out really cute. So I have these flowers that I can use. But I also have, I have a slew of flowers that I bought the other day. Only because they were on sale. I had a 40% off coupon for all the embellishments from Recollections. And then this, the girl was nice enough to use a 60% off on this because they are regularly priced. You had to have a coupon for them, which I had through the app. So she didn't use that coupon for this and gave me 60% off. And this was the most expensive. This was like $8.99 for all of these. So I got 60% off of that. So I think that's a good deal. These little ones were like $4.99. This was I think all of the rest of these were $4.99, if I'm not mistaken, with 40% off. So, yeah. So I have these flowers too, if I want to. And I think I do want to use some of these. Like, for instance, I think I have enough brown stuff, right? And so this rust looking color one is really, really got my attention. This one right there. Isn't that gorgeous? Ooh, it's so pretty. So I think if I put these two together, that'll work. Because I don't have much space because this is the medium size. And then maybe use, I am not familiar with these flower things at all. Like I said yesterday, I'm new to really all this paper crafting stuff. But what I love about these, and some may know it and some may not, but like you can take these and they have a little hole and you put your brads through it, right, to make your little flowers. So you can make them look whatever way that you want to. Isn't that just adorable? So I thought that was sweet. I'm not sure if I'll use those or the ones I made. I kind of think I want to use something in here. Maybe this one. Because I need some smaller flowers, I feel. If I can get the thing out. Come on out. It's like, no, I don't want to. Yeah, I think this would look pretty with it. Don't you think? Like if we had like this. I think that would look okay. Let's see what other one might look fine. Maybe this one. I'll get those two out. And then I have these little guys, but I think I have enough roses. I don't think I want to use any more roses. And then I have these that have an assortment of different ones. So let me see. Got any that will, I mean, of course we can use just the cream colored ones. That would be fine. It was hard for me because I couldn't remember exactly what color the paper was that I was going to use. So I kind of had to go by the seat of my pants. So we'll just try these for right now. This one might go. We'll put that one over. This one I don't think will go. All right, so let's just put these back. So let's just try this because I don't think I want a lot of flowers because the box is really not that big. And I think I'm going to do a passport little book for it. But we'll see because I also have this that I want to put on there. If I can find how to open it. It says explore. And I think I'm going to go ahead and paint it as well. Yeah, it says explore. I think that will be cute on there. And I think I'm going to go with the, I think I might mix the bronze and the copper. Why not? Let's see what that looks like. I have three of these. I mean, let me just see. Oh, that is the copper. That's the gold. Where's my bronze? There it is. Sorry. There. We'll just mix this together and we'll see what this turns out to be. I have no idea what it will look like. It might not look pretty at all. I'm going to do the back side. Just in case it's like, huh? Huh? It may not be the color that I want it to be. Maybe I should put some glitter on it. You know, that's always an option. Glitter. And here's just... You know, I think I'm gonna go... I think I'm going to go with just the copper. I think I'm going to go with just the copper. Okay, I have this color, which I think will go better than that. I'm going to try this color. Like I said, I have another. I have a couple of these, actually. I just want it on there a little. And it might not even stick this glue. I mean, this paint might already be dried. We'll try it. Just a little. Just a little splings. Just a tiny. Not too much. Okay, this R doesn't want to have any on there, but I want it to have some on there. Come on, get on there. You know you want it there, that's better. So there, I think that'll look pretty, right? All right, so let's let that dry completely. And let's clean up our mess. Okay, so while we're waiting for that to dry, this is what I've decided to use for the closure. I do have magnets that you can use, but I totally forgot because you would need to put like part of it underneath here and then part of it underneath here. And I forgot to do that. So I'm going to have to kind of do what I did with my last box, which is to use an ice screw. And this is the little knob, so to speak, that I'm going to use. I think it goes okay with that. Again, this came out of my bead stash that I've had. And then this little charm I thought was just too precious. And I hope it weighs enough to help keep the lid closed. So we will see if it does or not. It may not. But we'll see. And I will put a little O-ring on that, on this, and then attach it. And so, or I might use a little bit of string. I think I might use string instead. And so it'll hang down a little bit. I think that'll look cute. So, let's go ahead and do that while we're waiting on everything that I just did to dry. For me to decide if I want to use a... if I want to do the passport or not, because I'm not sure if I'm going to have room with all these flowers, the Explorer, and the globe. So, all right, I'm just going to find my center here. Let's see, that looks about as centered as it's going to get, maybe. Yeah. All right. And if I, well, here, let me do it this way. That way I have this little... the little hole that I can use. You kind of want it like right at the edge there, I think. Okay. Y'all are not seeing, sorry. Okay, so I'm gonna try to center this the best that I can. Maybe come down just a smidgen. And just poke the hole through. Okay. And then I'm just gonna feed this eye screw. Oop, these things are so tiny. Just gonna feed it up through that little hole. There we go. Alright, and I want it to be horizontal. Okay, and then I'm just going to use my fiber tack like I did last time. And I'm just going to put it over the screw like so. And then put the bead on top. There. And then it will adhere. All right. And then, let me get the string. Okay, I decided I'm going to use the string, and I don't even know where I got it. Probably the dollar store. I think I did get it at the dollar store for a buck. I like the way that looks. So, what I'm gonna do is, you know, just feed it through. That way it's kind of like a, looks like a tag maybe. I don't want it to dangle too much. That will be cut off, so. Okay. Let's see. My scissors, where did they go? I don't know. Okay, so I'm trying to figure this out. I think what I want to do is put a magnet on the back of the clock and put a magnet here, but I need to cover it though because I don't want it to show. So I have the magnet here. I mean, you look, it's ugly. It's just black. See? So I don't want that to show. So what I'm thinking is I have these stickers that go with the paper that I have, right? So I'm just wondering if I use a long sticker, like this goes, this is the inside paper right here. That sticker is. Oh dear. What to do? I think I'm going to try it. I think I'm going to try with this one that says Italy on it. I really am. I think it'll be long enough. Okay, so I think I'm going to go ahead and just glue it down. It's not sticking very well, and I'm using old magnet tape that I had. I mean, it's got a sticky back, but I really want it to stay. So I'm just going to use some of this fiber tack on it. Glue it down. And then also glue it on the back of the clock charm. And then I have this sticker I'm going to put over. And I'm hoping it will look okay once it gets dried and everything. So it says Italy on it. I'm just gonna go over it. I mean, it's gonna bunch up, but I can't help that. But at least it won't be so ugly. Ick, I don't like that. Well. Too late. Already committed. I should have thought about how I was going to close it before I put this paper on. But I didn't think that far in advance. So it's just going to have to look like this. I think is okay. I mean, it's still not closing though. It's still not keeping it closed. Okay, so from my spare parts, I got another clock to put on it. I'm gonna glue this. Okay, there's that. All right, let's let that dry. And while we're letting that dry, I'm gonna move it over. I'm gonna go ahead and glue the globe onto the stand. And I think I want it to look like that. And I'm just gonna use my matte medium. I think it'll work just fine. I'm gonna go over the top of it just to make sure that it adheres. Oh, that ends up being really cool. Really pretty. Okay. So there's the globe. Now, I'm gonna place, I think I'm gonna put the globe down. Then put explore over it. And then put the flowers in between those. Thank you. Okay, so I was racking my brain because I felt like I needed something over in this little corner up here. And I didn't want to do, I thought about doing like a little passport, but I didn't want to do that either, even though I could have fit it in like that, which I may eventually do. I don't know. I don't think so. I think I just like it like this. So I'm going to go ahead and glue these down because I think this looks cute. Like, well, that's it. I think it turned out too cute. I don't think it needs anything else. I think that it's adorable. I think who I'm going to give it to will appreciate it, warts and all. And if I hope that it inspired you to think of something that you can do. And again, you can make your own flowers. You don't have to buy your own. I mean, you don't have to buy any. You can make them, which I kind of dig the ones I've made, actually. I think they turned out really, really pretty. So if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, share it, and if you've not subscribed, hit that subscribe button below. And if you have subscribed, thank you, thank you, thank you. You know I appreciate it so, so much. Y'all be good to one another, and I will talk to you later. Bye!